Hey, Ashley. Ladies and gentlemen, we're running a little bit behind because the governor's stuck in traffic in downtown Hardeeville since all the police are out here. He's probably getting a ticket by now. We're going to go ahead and get started because the senator obviously has to be in D.C. very shortly. And we're going to ask the mayor to come up and introduce our senator, our senior senator from South Carolina. Mayor?
Good morning, everybody. Many of you probably don't know, but this has been a long time coming. And a couple of years ago, we were visited by Senator Graham, and he came to Jasper County Council. We even took a little golf cart ride, and he asked us what we needed. And we talked about widening of I-95. And of course, the big thing was getting Exit 3 for this region. Senator Graham, he heard our cry, and he took up our cause. Senator Graham, thank you very much. Please join us.
I like this place. You're right to the point. I apologize. I had to be in Charleston around 1 o'clock, so if there are any state troopers here, look the other way. So what was it, 3 years ago? I remember the golf cart ride, and that was kind of cool. But from the time I got out of my car to the time I left, you were on message, all of you. I've never seen a community so focused on trying to persuade someone of a need. And the reason we're here today is because that message was heard loud and clear by a lot of people. The governor, myself, everybody involved. Van Cato from my office has spent more time with the Corps of Engineers than probably the law would allow. So what we've done, Doug Smith, thank you very much for helping us here. To all the people involved, other than the Port of Charleston, I think this is the most transformative event in the state of South Carolina in terms of how it will change a region and a community. All positive. What you're going to have, Tom, and thank you, you've been like a dog with a bone on this thing, what you're going to have is an opportunity to bring business and new people to a county that needs all the help it can get. There are going to be jobs created in Jasper County that will benefit the entire region. There are going to be people moving to this part of South Carolina to have a chance to retire and raise a family. The county's budget is going to go up. You're going to have taxpayers. Yeah, you can clap for more money. You're going to have taxpayers you didn't have before. You're going to have a business footprint. And what does it mean for a young person growing up in this county? And this is a county that's been challenged in the past. This is a county that's been part of the I-95 problem. Well, the problem is about to get better. And all I can say is if you're a young person growing up in the county, you've got a chance to stay here for the rest of your life. You'll have a chance to get a job that wasn't available. There are going to be some world-class businesses come down here. So what do the rest of us have to do? We got to up our game. We got to make sure that our school systems are ready to meet the challenges of the 21st century so that our young people in Jasper County will have the skill set to work in these new businesses. We're going to have to make sure our police are growing, not lessening. Now's the time to increase the fire and police footprint to better serve the influx of people. The one thing I can say about the county, and I go to all of them, you want to get better. It is a team effort here. Black, white, rich, poor, no matter where you come from, everybody is working together to make it better than you found it. So as to my office, as long as I'm around, we're going to be in your corner advocating for you in Washington. Wherever we need our voice, you will have it because I am all in. God bless you all.
Thank you, Senator. And I know you have to leave in a few minutes.
Henry, I gotta run.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Governor, for being here. We're going to go ahead and start the program now, so we're going to back up a little bit, if you don't mind. First of all, we are under protocol because of the virus. We ask you that you wear your mask at all times. Distancing, and I know that's hard for some of us to do, but we do need to distance and follow the protocol. Let me first welcome everybody to today's event. This is a great day, as Senator has already said, and it's another great day in the Lowcountry. We've had a good month in the area. In Hampton County, that my good friend Shedron Williams participated over, we announced some great jobs there. That was 1,500 jobs plus 500 part-time jobs. This is bigger. If we take our region with this operation, with the operation in Hampton, and the governor's gonna help us with Savannah Riverside and the north side, this region will transform. So we're very much waiting for that. I look around this and I wanna recognize a few people that made this happen. And they're very bashful people, so you have to seek them out. But in the back is the Stratford Group. Rob Unal, OC's there. This could not have been done without you guys. Obviously, you started this more than 12 years ago now, I guess. We all had black hair and mustaches back in those days, and of course, that's all changed. Thank you for being here. Doug and Charlie, working with them directly, and we know how much work you have put into this thing and pulling it together. We appreciate what you've done. Our delegation, our State House delegation, I know Shedron is here from the area. Wes was going to be here. Is he here? He's not. Okay. He should be here in a little bit. I'm sorry. Who am I missing? We're going to introduce her in a minute. She's too important right now. I'm sorry. Bill's here? Oh, Bill's supposed to be here too, but I don't think either one have made it yet. We'll recognize them when they do get here. I do also want to recognize a couple of other people. Mayor from Bluffton, Lisa Sokol, has come. There she is. We appreciate you coming over. Chairman of Beaufort County Council, Joe Passman, is here. Chairman from Hampton County, Clay Bishop. I know Clay's sitting up front. Thank you all for coming over. This is a regional event, as we all know. I also want to recognize our development partners that are already here in these beautiful buildings you see in, going up. Peter Goulding. Hey, Pete, come up some so everybody can see who you are. Some of us may need a job soon. And we're going to have a new partner being introduced in just a little while, so bear with us on that. 12 years ago. Sherwood, I'm selling another piece of land already. Stratford Land came into the area and they decided they wanted to develop this thousands of acres in this area. OC and his team, working with Lamar Mercer and the Thomas and the Hutton Group, who've drawn these pictures for us, but more importantly, they've laid out this park over the years, and it's going to be a fantastic operation. This was supposed to be the development area on 95, serving the two ports, but also the gateway to the Jasper Ocean Terminal, which some of us will be able to see and some of us may not when it's completed in 30 years or 40 years, but hopefully it will be. This stretch of road will be exit 3, and we got to thank everybody, Senator Davis, coalition from Jasper County, the town of Hardeeville, and others that participated in that. That was just completed. So this is going to be an interstate interchange going back into 95 soon. And all this development going on, it's going to be a wonderful opportunity for everyone. And we appreciate what everybody has done in making that happen. And Governor, we can't say enough about what you did to help us with this. You are truly the rural economic development governor. And we thank you for that. And we appreciate what you've done so far. Along with Governor McMaster, we have an all-star lineup of speakers today. You've already seen the senator. The first person up is going to be the mayor of Hardeeville, Mayor Harry Williams. He's been around for many, many years, and we'll have him speak in just a few moments. Joining the governor, today is going to be the chairman of Jasper County, Henry Etheridge. Henry's sitting up front here. Our state senatorial delegation with Senator Marjorie Bright Matthews and Senator Tom Davis. And then we'll finish out after that's done today. So, Mayor, I'm going to ask you, no, I'm sorry, we've got to have the invocation. I'm sorry, I'm getting out of line already. To do the invocation is the chairman of SCA, our board, as well as he sits on Jasper County Council. Hey, Wes, come on up so everybody can see you. Good to have you. Appreciate you coming. Come up here and sit in the senator's chair. Yes, sir. I've known Marty Sauls for quite a while, and obviously we work very closely together in some of the stuff in this county, but also across six other counties that we've been working on these things. And it gives me great pleasure to bring him up. He leads everything, Chamber of Commerce, the Knights of Columbus, everything you possibly think of, he's chairman of. So, Marty, I'm going to ask you to come on up, please, sir.
You can tell I sign his checks. So it's a pleasure to see everybody here today. And what a great day to celebrate such an awesome, awesome project. You know, there's a lot of people who have worked hard on this for the past decade, and that's really mind-boggling if you think about it, the amount of effort and the amount of collaboration we've had through so many people, partners, elected officials, companies, consultants, engineers. It truly is amazing, and it's good to see OC Vest here. And he and I were reminiscing back almost, 10 or 11 years ago, and we made our first presentation to the SIB board. OC, it's amazing that we're here today and celebrating. So, but let's celebrate who's really made this possible. So if y'all will bow your heads and let's go to the Lord in prayer. Our most kind and gracious Heavenly Father, we humbly bow our heads and we just give thanks to you, dear Lord, because we know without you, nothing is possible. Dear Lord, we pray that this project will be the difference in our county and in our region. It's going to make huge differences in our citizens' lives, the benefits and resources that it'll create, dear Lord, that's going to change our entire layout of our Low Country region, dear Lord. And we just thank you so much for what this means, for your guidance. And dear Lord, we just know that everything we're going to do will be pleasing in your sight. Dear Lord, we ask a safe return home today as we leave this event, dear Lord, and we just ask these things in your holy and precious name. Amen. I tell you, I've introduced our next speaker so many times, I don't even need any Post-it cards to remind me on what to say. But the mayor of the city of Hardeeville moved here in 2015, and I remember the first time I met him was in the hallway at City Hall, and I don't think that Harry had been here but a few months. And immediately I liked him because I thought he was a local. And, after a few fixing twos and, a couple of bless your hearts, he's definitely a local in my book now. But he's originally from Mahwah, New Jersey. He graduated from Rutgers University, and he and his wife Beth moved here in 2015. He was a veteran of the footwear industry for 42 years. And has served as the mayor for the city of Hardeeville since 2015. He serves on the Chamber Board of Directors. He's the chairman of So Loco Group and is involved in so many things. And I can tell you that it means a lot to me to see how involved he is, especially for his short tenure here in the Lowcountry. You can truly see that he genuinely cares about our home, now his home, the people here, and the future of our community. He really takes it to heart. But today is also a very special, special day, besides the fact of what we're celebrating. But today is Mayor Williams' birthday. So normally, yes, well, it's fixing to get better, y'all. Normally, being the southern gentleman that I try to be, I would sing happy birthday to Harry. But I want the governor to come back, so I thought we may do it as a group to kind of drown me out. So on three. One, two, three. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Harry. Happy birthday to you. Ladies and gentlemen, Harry Williams, the mayor of the city of Hardeeville. Harry!
I owe you, buddy.
Bless your heart.
Bless your heart.
How do I get up here now after that? Y'all should know, though, I'm like Jack Benny. This is my 39th birthday again. Governor, you're old enough. You remember that, right? Welcome to Hardeeville, everyone. We come here today upon a road long traveled. And I can tell you firsthand, the trip back from Columbia at times was a drive through a valley of tears. But the dream was kept alive by an amazing show of teamwork. Governor McMaster became our champion, and his unflinching support made all the difference. Senator Graham, I already spoke about. Senator Scott gave us this amazing Opportunity Zone legislation. Our state delegation, they echoed our cry in Columbia, and their continual support kept our hopes high. And here with us today are Senator Tom Davis, Senator Margie Bright Matthews, Representative Chevron Williams, Representative Weston Newton, and Representative Bill Herb Kirstman was also very instrumental. The Southern Carolina Alliance and Mr. Danny Black, along with Stratford Land, never lost sight of the vision. Grambling Brothers recognized the potential and joined our crusade. Our partners, Jasper County, led by Mr. Andy Fogum, was here from the beginning. And every council chair for the past 12 years, four of whom still serve us today. And here from the Jasper County Council, Councilwoman Barbara Clark. We have Councilman Tom Johnson here. I thought I saw him. And we have Councilman Marty Sauls and our current chair, Councilman Henry Etheridge. We also have the school board, led by Dr. Rochelle Anderson, who gave us strength when we needed it most. And I'd like the school board, we have many representatives, to please stand and be recognized. And last, but certainly not least, our city manager, Mr. Michael J. Simbor, and the staff of Hardeeville who navigated us through this very complicated process. And I'd like to introduce the Hardeeville City Council who is with us today. Our Mayor Pro Tem, Mrs. Carolyn Castle. Councilman Judge John Carroll. Councilman David Spezo. And Councilman Bo White. Now just think about all these moving parts. We've got elected officials, private industry, the school board, all working together cooperatively to achieve a common goal, to serve the public welfare. This is just a great example of what we can accomplish when we all work together as a united team. This team has brought us a new road, a new exit, new industry, new tax revenues for our city, our county, and our schools. This is, I thought I had this down. Now, all these things are wonderful, right? But that is not why we are here today. We are here to celebrate the people of South Carolina, people who will now enjoy the chance to improve the quality of their lives and the lives of their family, people who are rudderless in their career will now find job opportunities that heretofore were not available in this part of the state. Students will now see new reasons to finish their high school education. This isn't about a new road. This is about a new corridor of opportunity for the people we serve. It must always be about the people. So, Governor McMaster, Senators Graham and Scott, Senator Davis, Senator Bright Matthews, Representative Newton and Williams and Herb Kirstman, and all this amazing team, on behalf of the people of Hardeeville, on behalf of the people of the Lowcountry and on behalf of all the people of South Carolina, we thank you for bringing us real change for real people. Okay, now I get to do the good spot. I now have the great honor to introduce to you our governor, Henry McMaster. The governor has led our state since January 2017, but he has been serving the people of South Carolina for over 40 years as U.S. Attorney, Attorney General, and Lieutenant Governor. He has led the Republican Party and as Lieutenant Governor headed the Office on Aging. He has served on the South Carolina Commission on Higher Education, the South Carolina Ports Authority, and the South Carolina Policy Council. The people of South Carolina have been Governor McMaster's lifelong passion. And so it should come as no surprise that he has supported job creation and new opportunities for the people of rural South Carolina. The governor has worked closely with the Southern Carolina Alliance and our state delegates in the support of the Jasper Ocean Terminal, the widening of I-95, the recruitment of industry to the Lowcountry, and now Exit 3. Governor, you have shown that you believe in the concept that a rising tide lifts all boats, and rural South Carolina has been the beneficiary of your admiralship. Sir, may the people of rural South Carolina be your legacy. Please welcome our esteemed Governor, Henry McMaster.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Beautiful words. I appreciate that. And it is a pleasure to be here. And I do have to follow up on what the mayor said. I am proud of the people of South Carolina. And it is all about the people. And when I speak to businesses from all around the world that are looking for places to invest hundreds of millions and billions of dollars, hundreds of millions and billions of dollars, they always say the reason is, among others, is the people of South Carolina. It's the people. Mark Clark, the general four-star who's later president of Citadel, said that there's more patriotism per square inch in South Carolina than any place in the world. And I think that runs through all of us. However we got here, however long we've been here, the things that we've dealt with over the centuries, it makes us different. And I'm very proud of that. I'll be brief. I want to add my thanks to all those who worked to and had the vision to get this started, who understood the need for this. And I want to tell you a quick little story about recognizing things. As the family moved into town and they were looking for a church to go to, and the daddy was taking his little boy, and they were going around looking at the churches, the big ones, the small ones. And they went into one, and they were walking around, looked at the big building out in the graveyard. And the man said to his son, he said, "Look, son, this is an old church. This is a monument here to all the men who have died in the service." And he says, the boy says, "Died in the service?" Dad says, "Yeah, all the men have died in the service." He said, "Which one, 11 o'clock at 8:30? Okay, you got it. I want to thank Lindsey Graham. I wanted to say this while he was here, but Lindsey Graham is unstoppable. He is an energy machine. He gets more things done for our state and you've heard the old expression in politics, Senator Margie Bright Matthews, what have you done for me lately? Well, I want to tell you, we've got F-35 fighter jets being built in Greenville. Excuse me. The F-35s are coming to the Marine Air Corps. It's the F-15s that are being built in Greenville at Lockheed Martin. It was Lindsey Graham who got the money put in the budget by the Corps of Engineers to deepen the Charleston Harbor. If he hadn't been there, Tom Davis, as you well know, if he hadn't been there for us, we wouldn't be deepening that harbor. And that harbor is an economic engine. This is going to be an economic engine. whenever we need something in Washington, we are so fortunate to have Lindsey Graham and Tim Scott. We're on the phone all the time. We're in meetings together, whether the president or somebody else. And we have a great team. Mr. Mayor, you put your finger on it. With the delegation here, those that you mentioned, it's like that all around the state. We're able to pivot. We can turn on a dime. We can get things done quickly. And I'll tell you, I think it's unique, Wes, in the country. That's what these businesses that come from outside tell me when they look at us. They say South Carolina is different. In fact, we all know each other. A lot of us, Chevron, we're related. And Lindsey Graham makes the joke. He said when he was a young lawyer up in Oconee, he'd have a lot of country people come in to see him. And a lot of times they'd ask funny questions. And one of them they'd ask, they'd say, well, say, Mr. Lawyer, let me ask, if we are married in South Carolina and divorced in Georgia, are we still cousins? Well, that means that we know each other. And my rule is collaborate, communicate, cooperate. Break down the barriers, the silos that keep us from talking to each other. Because when you take the people of South Carolina with the experience, with the determination, and with the character that Mark Clark and others mentioned, and you put that where we're talking together to get things done, we can excel quicker, faster, and better, I believe, than any place in the country. And another thing I think is going to do well for us, in this virus, the way that we have all responded by not going into a lockdown as they did in some other states, we know now that's not necessary to do that. You have to be smart. You have to target. We didn't go into it like they did in some other states, locking down manufacturers, locking down businesses. Some of them still are unlocked today. And we came out of it. Targeted, softly, and as a result, I believe that we're going to do better than the other states. And that adds one more thing. There are businesses around the country that have failed because of unnecessary restrictions put on them. If you're smart, if you collaborate and you communicate and you cooperate, you can do the right things to serve the people without destroying their livelihoods. And that's what we've done in South Carolina. So this particular project is one that was a long time coming, but it is here. And that Jasper Ocean Terminal is going to be here one day too, Tom Davis, with your leadership. But this is going to open things up, Mr. Mayor, as you've said. And so I'll finish by saying that our future is bright. All we have to do is be careful, is communicate, collaborate, work with each other, understand what the Constitution means, understand that we cannot prosper unless we educate the children of South Carolina. South Carolina's business is business. South Carolina's business is business, large businesses, small businesses. And a part of that, inextricably woven into it, is the education of the young people in South Carolina. So if we understand those things and we keep our eyes on things that will lead us there and not lead us to distractions in the side, I think that our future is so bright. The road to prosperity is right here. This is another example of it, and there will be more. There will be more coming, and I look forward to working with all of you to see that it happens. I believe South Carolina is the best place in the world to live, work, and raise a family, and this today proves it. Thank you.
Thank you, Governor. It's always a pleasure to hear you speak. Anytime we get a chance without having to pay for it, it's even better. But it's always fun. We want to introduce our newest partner to the region. He is going to do tremendous things out here. As you can see by the boards, there's a lot of plans. You look over this board on my left, your right, that's several million square feet of office space, of manufacturing space, of warehouse spacing to serve the ports of Charleston and Savannah, and hopefully they'll be going up very soon. I want to introduce the architect behind that. He has served this country tremendously. In the military, he went to a military college that we won't talk about because you don't have a football team there. But he served this country in that role. He's now serving the Lowcountry in the role of a developer and partner for this region, and we're very proud of him. And I want to bring up Michael Harper.
Thank you, Danny, and thank you for all the vision and work you have done to get this project to this point. We feel very fortunate at Grambling Brothers to have this great opportunity. And I'll echo something I've heard a couple of times already today. This has been a long time coming. And we talk about just in terms of Stratford's moving this project forward over the last 12 years, but and piggybacking off of something that Senator Graham said early, I was born and raised in Estill, obviously in Hampton County, and so I know Hardeeville very well. In fact, I always had a fond spot for it because there's a road sign on I-95 that shows the way to Estill. Exit 5 has Estill on it, and I can assure you it is the only one in this world. But as somebody who's from this particular area and as somebody who left, I'd like to just echo what Senator Graham said, and that is this. It is time for this area to have more jobs and to have more opportunities for folks who grow up here and who are from this area. It shouldn't be a question of whether they leave or stay. There should be enough opportunity here for everybody. And that's what we feel like this project is. This project is a great opportunity. We're just fortunate to be at the right place at the right time. We thank the governor for obviously spearheading this new interchange, and I believe that it might be easier to get here by 11, Governor, when the new interchange is in, too. So, but this obviously would not have happened without his great help and Danny's help, obviously, and Senator Graham and Senator Scott. The fact that this is an opportunity zone is a difference maker for developers of real estate, and obviously this is a very environmentally sensitive area, and we plan to develop the project responsibly. Senator Graham and his office have been a great help to us in handling that particular portion of the project. We don't believe that developers necessarily make the decision on how land is developed. We believe the land has the main say in that. And this particular piece of property is ready to be developed, and we see this as being a tremendous job creator for this particular area of the Lowcountry. And so we're blessed to have the opportunity, and we intend to do our best in it. So thank you to everyone.
Thank you, Michael. I know you're bringing the bulldozers out tomorrow, right? Let me, real quickly, for the media's sake, I want to make sure y'all have an opportunity at the end of the session to talk some of the heroes here. But I'm going to introduce the next four speakers, and they'll come up. The Honorable Chairman of Jasper County County Council, Henry Etheridge, who's been around forever and has been involved in this stuff forever. He's done a tremendous job. We appreciate your leadership. We know that you've been a little taken aback with some illnesses and so forth, but you worked through it and have been a tremendous force in getting all this done. So I want to recognize him. Before he comes up, I also want to recognize the previous mayor, Bronco Bostic, who's sitting here, who started this thing off 49 years ago, whatever it's been. Mayor Malthus from Ridgeland. I failed to mention you a while ago, and I was looking dead at you, and I, just an old man, just forgot to say it. I want to tell you how much we appreciate what you have done in council from Ridgeland. So with that, I'm going to introduce Chairman Etheridge, and he'll be followed by Superintendent Anderson. And to wrap up, our two senatorial delegation members, Senator Matthews and Senator Davis. Mr. Chairman.
As Andy said, I've been around a long time. In fact, this project, I was 65 years old when this project started, and now I'm 77 years old, if you want to know how long it's been started. But I want to thank everybody that's had a part in making this happen. I don't think we went to anybody that we couldn't get answers from or get help when we needed it in this project. I was looking this morning, should have looked earlier, but I found a brochure from 2010. I don't throw much away when they give it to me in paper. But in 2010 was the first presentation made to the two municipalities and the county about this project. And I left there, of course, I was, like I say, I was 65 at that time, and I left there when I was 67, dancing about that high. The biggest thing I'd heard of in Jasper County in many, many years. But I'm here today to thank the people that was involved and all of the people that had collective efforts and many, many stakeholders, and that was the Stratford Company. I understand when he made this announcement in Texas that they kind of said, well, that can't be. That can't be, 5,100 acres. But he evidently proved them wrong. I want to thank Stratford Company. I certainly want to thank Southern Carolina Alliance. They've been on top of it. South Carolina Department of Commerce, the governor of South Carolina, North Signal Capital, EJF Investments, Evans Contractors, Thomas & Hutton, LS3P and CBRE, and also the City of Hardeeville and Jasper County. Jasper County appreciates the investment of EJF Capital and North Signal Capital in constructing these large spec buildings, which are huge, very huge marketing tools for attracting jobs and investment. Economic development has been my priority since I have been on the council for 12 years, and it has worked. Look back 12 years ago at where we were in economic development and look at where we are now. There's going to be 10 of these buildings as planned, with a total square footage of about 4 million square feet. And the first building, which was finished last month, is on my right, your left, my right, was finished earlier this month, 152,000 square foot in Riverport One. This is called Riverport One. And has a major national retailer, has signed a 10-year lease, and this announcement will be coming soon. Directly behind me, the next building, with walls going up now, is a 329,000 square foot building that will be completed in late January or early February. So we're getting a good start. You can also see the new City of Hardeeville Fire Station, and I think, Harry, am I right, over here? Back in here. Anyway, the new fire station that will be that's going to be needed for safety in this area. Riverport Park is a prime candidate to house manufacturing tenants as well. Our business-friendly environment, our large pool of skilled employees, including exiting military people, we have 3 military bases very close to us, so we're going to have a lot of people exiting the military, are important factors for manufacturers considering site locations. I'd also say that the South Carolina Port, the Georgia Port, and soon to be, our Jasper Ocean Terminal plays a huge part in the site selection for manufacturers. So we have room for them. We have room to grow in Riverport. Jasper County is one of the fastest growing areas in our great state of South Carolina, and we are proud of our Jasper County growth. I just can't say enough about Riverport. It excited me more than anything that had ever happened to me when they made this announcement in 2010. Again, I want to thank stakeholders. I want to thank our legislature. I want to thank all the councils of our municipalities and our mayors, because we have all been able to work together. I also want to thank Mr. Bronco Bostic. He was mayor at the time that this thing was getting started. And he approached a man in our area that one of our congressmen, Mr. Joe Wilson, about getting funds for Exit 3. So that's how long we've been working on Exit 3, like 2019, I think. And it's finally happened. It's finally happened. The road coming through Riverport is finally happening. So we can't do nothing but grow, and I am proud of it. It means jobs for our future. All of my immediate family live in Jasper County. And what I would like to see is all of them work in Jasper County. At this time, they can't, but I want to see them all work in Jasper County. And I want to see all your children, grandchildren work in Jasper County. Thank y'all for coming today, and we're all excited about this project and about what's happening in South Carolina. Thank you.
The function of education is to teach one to think intensively and to think critically. Intelligence plus character, that is the goal of true education. Dr. Martin Luther King, Jr. On the behalf of our Board of Trustees, and we do have several who are here with us today, and we acknowledge them for their presence and their continued support, and our administration in Jasper County School District, greetings to each of you. Protocol and acknowledgments have been established, and I am certain that you understand that we share and I share the same respect for all who are present here today and for all of you who have made this opportunity possible. To our local delegation, I truly appreciate you. You always call, you always make sure that what we need in Jasper County School District for our scholars, you hear us. And I would be remiss by not saying something special to Representative Shedron Williams for always calling. My phone, for some reason, I wake up at 1 o'clock and there's a text, just making sure that he understands what our needs are. To Mayor Williams, a special thank you to you for your vision and for your continued support and for the opportunity for me to share just a few remarks today on the behalf of our scholars, our school system, and Jasper County. This is a momentous occasion, and we are very, very proud to be a part of it. It is with great pleasure that I stand before you today to share a few remarks on the behalf of Jasper County School District, where our mantra, our vision, and our motto is student-centered, future-focused. To Governor McMaster, and to all who made it possible for our scholars of Jasper County School District to be one of the first to take part in the South Carolina ETV Data Casting Initiative. Thank you. This is an example of great opportunities that are made possible when we collectively work together. Today is another great example of the opportunity that exists for our scholars here in Jasper County School District. The development of Exit 3 is a milestone that is the epitome of setting a firm foundation that will assist in establishing positive outcomes for our young people and their future ahead. I challenge each of you here today to continue providing the needed resources for our scholars and for our educators in Jasper County School District by expanding bandwidth and or broadband services in our area, providing reoccurring funding for technology devices with data for the entire year for all students enrolled in K-12 facilities, providing reoccurring funding for upgrading devices for those that may be needed to be replaced, those that are lost, those that are damaged, ensuring reoccurring funding for effective ongoing professional development for staff, funding for data devices for teachers, ensuring that all schools become e-learning facilities so that learning continues without fail, and funding for the support needed for training our parents, our guardians, for those students, so that they understand how to effectively use the technology devices, such as an innovative parent academy. On the behalf of the Board of Trustees and administration, we look forward to working with each of you on the behalf of our scholars with a challenging education that builds academic capacity, cultivates creativity, advocates lifelong learning, and promotes respect for self and others. We are hashtag One Jasper. We are hashtag Jasper Strong. May God bless each of you.
Good morning. It is good to be here, and it's finally, we're finally one step closer to all of our dreams in this region. Governor, Cousin McMaster, thank you. That's an old family joke, but thank you so much for all that you've done to not only spearhead this, push it forward, and keep the ball rolling. But thank you for your patience in listening to us over and over beg for this. And many times, I think my senior senator, Senator Davis, probably did some dancing for it. But thank you so much. And to Senator Davis, the senior senator from our delegation, thank you for when I first became a senator, I knew that my predecessor, this was something he worked on with you. And I asked Senator Davis, I said, Senator, can you please give me all the information? Well, no, I didn't ask for all. The information I need so that I will know where I need to be in working with you to move this whole Jasperport dream forward. And little did I know I would get a stack of papers like this, overkill. And I'd give it to me in a nutshell. But anyway, what I learned was, in him providing me this, was that this, his work on this port and Exit 3 started before he became a senator. It started when he worked in the governor's office. So I knew how invested he was in this, and I want to thank you for all that you've done for this region, because I'm going to tell you, this region is a region of us being together. It's not about the R's, it's not about the M's, it's about us. We're together in this. And when we succeed, when we individually succeed, we all succeed. Thank you. To my delegation members, Representative Newton, Representative Williams, and Representative Herb Kirschman in his absence, I want to thank you for every time we needed to knock on the governor's door or knock on Senator Graham's door or Ray's devil. Thank you for being there. This exit is on the backs of the vision of this whole region. I can think of someone that is smiling down on us today, and I know most of you know who that is, my predecessor. I did not expect that I would be here as a senator for Jasper County, but I did know his commitment. The week before Senator Pinckney died, we were to meet on the Wednesday to talk about his reelection. I just remember my conversations with him saying that this port and this region and job creations was his number one goal. He oftentimes said, I don't want to be a senator for long. I just want to get that accomplished for my people. We have to at least give him a prayer at this time, because it is, I'm sure he's happy. And he's going to be continually pushing us on as our angel to get this port to its finality. And yes, Governor, we're gonna keep begging for an earlier date than what has been given to us. I might as well go ahead and say it. Mayor of Hardeeville, thank you so much for all you're doing. But I usually have Chief Alexander from Yemisee drive me as my driver when I go to events because they're the ones that usually stop me, so I might as well have the chief drive me. So, but I kicked the chief to the curb this morning, and I called and asked for former Mayor Bronco Bostic to drive me to this event. And boy, was it a difference. I said, you're driving me, won't you? You don't have to go 35 in Richland. I'm with you. And but you know why I realized it wasn't about the speed limit. He wanted to slow down to tell me all he'd done for this port. And so he was telling me all the, I said, this ain't about you, but really it is. He was telling me all the things that I already knew about that he did in calling Congressman Tim Scott and getting him involved in this in the many meetings they've had. So I want to say publicly, my pseudo driver, former Mayor Bronco Bostic, thank you so much for all you do and have done for this region. And believe it or not, all that he's going to continue to do if I know him. And I want to thank Congressman Joe Wilson, too, for being there for us. A man has only one thing in this world. Not the possessions. It's not anything. The true mark of a man's character is how he keeps his word. Your word is all you have. That's all my dad always told me. All you have is your word. And Governor, thank you for keeping your word to Jasper County. Now, it was only a couple of weeks ago when I went into the Senate for a meeting. It was the day that Hampton County, with the help of the wonderful folks, and I'm not going to only say Danny Black because I know he's just a figurehead. The other girls do all the real work. But it was just a couple of weeks ago when we had an announcement in Hampton County of 1,500 jobs over a period of time and $315 million investment. Boy, was I on cloud nine. Now, we all know that 2020 has been like a crazy year, right? It's been like, I call it the crazy girlfriend from, what's that movie with Glenn Close in it? Stalking you? Fatal Attraction. 2020 has been like that. But you know, Hampton County and Jasper County has been blessed in spite of the dogmas of 2020. So after we had that announcement over in Hampton, boy, I was so happy. I knew this Tom left before me, but I sped going 85 miles per hour, y'all didn't hear this, to Columbia because I wanted to be the one to announce to my Senate colleagues and said, nanny, nanny, we got $350 million investment and 1,500 jobs. And they asked, many of my colleagues asked, how did you do that? I said, just hard work. Mr. Black, I knew you would like that. I took all credit for it. But it was a collaborative effort, and thank you so much for that. And now, guess what? We go back into session tomorrow, and I'm going to do it again. Are you going to be there with me, Senator? Well, I'm going to tell them what Riverport is going to be about and what Exit 3 is about, because you know why? It was the help of people in the Senate like Senator Hugh Leatherman, Senator Davis, and several others that helped move Exit 3 forward. And you have to give credit where it's due. They moved this forward, and it's because of this that the education is going to be different in this area. It's because of this that we're going to have job creations. It's because of this that the quality of life, it will change in this area. It's because of this that health care will be impacted. It is because of this that we all will be able to expect that our kids and grandkids will want to move back to Jasper County. And Governor, you don't know it, and this is not about politics, but at the end of your speech, I changed the end of mine because you gave my campaign slogan. It is because of this that our future is bright.
Good afternoon, or good morning, or afternoon, maybe. I'm going to be very brief. Everybody has been thanked. Everybody has been acknowledged. But I do want to draw attention to Governor McMaster once again. The attention that you've shown to Hampton County, Jasper County, the rural areas, truly extraordinary. By way of measure, let me just say this. There was $360 million to be spent this year by the State Infrastructure Bank on roads and bridges. Our region got half of that, almost $180 million. That is because of the hard work of our delegation. It's because of the hard work of county and municipal leaders. It's because of the leadership of the governor. And I'm just going to say this. We had an announcement in Hampton of 1,500 jobs, $315 million worth of investment. As Danny said, this is even bigger. We're going to have another announcement in regard to the Sherwood track soon. We're going to have more announcements in regard to the Jasper County Ocean Terminal. We are going to see the next 10 years. This is our 10 years. Now, I'm a state senator, and I love our state. I love Columbia. I love Charleston. I love Greenville. But I love our region. And it's our region's turn. And our region for the next 10 years is going to lead the way in job opportunities and economic growth. And we're going to show the way. And I look forward to being alongside with you to make that happen. Thank you.
You see why we left our two senators to last to wrap this up. Thank y'all very much.